Thank you for watching Mini Me, guys. I appreciate it. Tonight, we're going to go ahead and talk about a HP build. But before we do that, there's a few things I want to cover. You may be wondering how I got all these rings that you see here in my shared bank, and I'll explain that a little later. Along with that, you're probably also wondering how come I have so many retraining tokens. I will also cover that here in just a moment, so stay tuned. You don't have to have as many characters as I do, but the more characters you have, the more retraining tokens you can get. The majority of my characters are level 70. Due to praying and also completing my professions. So I haven't really played with them or completed any missions. So if that's your case, make sure you talk to Surgeon Knox, accept all the missions as I just did there. I'm gonna try to make this as quick as possible. Hop! Smash! Make sure you talk to this guy and accept all the missions as well. Alright, now what we wanna do is open up the chest, make sure you've completed those missions. Make sure you've talked to every single one of them, so that way you've completed all the missions before you get into the gate. Before we enter the gate, if you have not completed the crown, make sure you abandon it. So that way you can get in there and retrieve your retraining token. Hop! Smash! Again! Talk to this beautiful lady. And talk to her again. Make sure you've accepted all the missions.
The Sword Coast Chronicle is a list of the heroic deeds and campaigns your hero may complete in Neverwinter.
Collect all the Symbols of Severus, which you need at least 7 of them in order to gain your retraining token. The ones that you have completed will show up in green, so that way you know you can go ahead and accept the Symbol of Severus, and you can gain your retraining token.
Deeds grant rewards on completion. They also grant Symbols of Severus. These can be redeemed with Cybella for additional rewards.
Smash! Let's go ahead and bring up the share bank so we can put it in there with the rest of the other ones. That's the good part about this, is that you can use them on a different character. Alright, now that we're back, we're going to use at least 3 retraining tokens. You may be wondering why 3 of them. Well, good news. I'm going to be doing an HP build, a PvE build, and a PvP build. I have gotten a tremendous amount of requests for a PvE build. And don't worry guys, I'm not going to let you down. How about 52,000 power for a GF? How does that sound? I will probably also tie it in at the very end of this video. So make sure to check that out guys. Now what we're going to do is concentrate on the build that we're doing now. Which is going to be 250,000 HP. Or 252,000 to be exact. As you noticed, I'm just kind of scrolling by all the enchantments that I have, so you guys can see exactly what I'm using in order to maintain that 250,000 HP. As far as the HP is concerned, it's good for any class. It doesn't have to be just a GF. It could be any other class. So this video will be very useful to you regardless what your class is. Once I go through the feed section, it may not apply to you if you're not a GF. But stay tuned if you want to rock that 250,000 HP or whatever your character or whatever the goal is that you're trying to achieve. As you notice right there, as I showed you really quick, that's my PvP setup currently at the moment. Let's go ahead and open up a retraining token so we can go ahead and respect our character. Alright, now that we have respected our character, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick Iron Vanguard. Because that's the setup I like for PvP, guys. Under the ability score, we're going to pick Strength and Constitution. Strength gives us Strength, Stamina, and Constitution will give us HP, or Hit Points. And since our main focus is on Hit Points, we're going to make sure that we'll select in everything that's associated with Hit Points. Currently, right now, we're at 99,000, as you can notice there. Let's jump under the feet section. So under the feet section, the first thing we're going to pick is the one at the bottom. This gives us an extra 9% of more hit points. I would love to go on details in every single one of them, but this video will take way too long. And if you want a detailed video, make sure you check the link on the description below. I already have a GF for PvP build that explains everything on details as far as a damage burst GF, which is the GF I like to play. Now, there's a lot out there that likes to play a tanky GF, that's your choice, but I like to smash. You guys know me, right? For the Hulk smash. This one, I normally don't select it. The reason why is because it's related to damage over time. If you smash somebody with a crit hit, it's going to continue damaging them, and if it's another GF or another class, they're more likely to heal with their Insignia bonuses. We will go ahead and select it this time, since we're focusing on HP. It will help us to heal in return. The bigger the hit points, the bigger the heals, guys. And I'll explain that later as well, under the Insignia bonuses. The reason why I'm picking this one is because my stamina always runs low. So if this is going to help us take 10% less damage from all sources, it'll be good for us. Let's go ahead and submit. Let's go back to the main character sheet. As you noticed, we're up to 107. Now, this is the important part for you guys that may be useful to every class out there, as the boons are same for everyone. The reason why I picked the top one is so it can give us an extra 500 more speed. And then we'll go ahead and pick the bottom one, as the other ones are pretty useless. Under the boon section, our focus is going to be on hit points, HP. So whatever gives us HP is what we're going to do is select it. So here we have HP versus action point gain. What we're going to do is pick HP, as this video is focusing on HP, guys. So don't judge me, or go ahead and judge me. Make sure you leave it on the comments below, guys. Your comments are much appreciated. Also along the way, make sure you smash that like button. All the classes are different from one another. The reason why I'm not going to go on details to why I'm picking which one is because every class is different. For example, a GF doesn't really do much crit. So picking all the crit boons will increase your crit chance. However, then you will lack on your deflection. A lot of other classes out there, such as a TR or an HR, will do crit regardless. So your best bet is picking your deflection boons instead. Every class is different depending on your stats, depending on your gear score. You really don't know until you go and play PvP what you're lacking of. If it's deflection you're lacking of, then you want to respect and pick the deflection boons. If it's power you're lacking of, then you want to go ahead and respect and pick all the power boons. But you have to find that perfect level, guys, until you get it exactly the way you like to play on your playstyle. Or you can mirror the previous GF builds that I have, and then just adjust to that. The biggest advice I can give you as far as Neverwinter is concerned in playing in PvP or PvE, it's definitely based on your build, but it's more based on your skill. And I know this game is paid to win, but it makes it available for those people that don't have too much time to play, such as myself, who are constantly working, making YouTube videos, and just don't have the time to play all the content. The game does give you the option to actually purchase the boons and few other things. But one thing your master enchantment credit card won't buy is knowledge. If you have knowledge about your character and how it works, you'll know how to stack all the buffs. You'll know how to do the rotation. So yeah, money is not really going to buy you knowledge that you need in order to succeed in PvP or PvE. You may be able to kill some pugs. You'll never be able to kill somebody that's been playing this game for quite some time. Because one, they're going to be over probably 4k score, and two, they probably have all the knowledge, especially if you're in a guild. As guildies, they do talk to one another and share all the secrets. I see a lot of people rolling around with mythic mounts and using the special capability to take advantage, especially in PvP. But I have no problem with my regular mount. Just make sure you're taking advantage of all the Insignia bonuses, so that way you can get all your heals and all your power and everything else that comes along with it. Okay, so here we have another choice between 1600 HP versus power. Of course, we're going to go ahead and pick HP, guys. Every little bit helps. Alright, here we are under the Guild Boon. I like to pick that one at the bottom as it gives you bigger heals when you're in PvP. And I like to pick the mount when I'm playing PvE. So that way I can go to places faster. On this one you can choose to pick armor penetration or power. It depends on who you're fighting, I guess. That's what I like about these boons is that you have the option to change it in a matter of seconds. Let's go ahead and pick the HP boon, and then we'll go back to our main character sheet here in just a moment and take a look and see what our hit points look like. Thank you for sticking around. I do appreciate it. I hope this video is going to be helpful to you. Stay tuned, as the next step once we're done with the boons is going to be to put all the enchantments into the defense slots, so that way we can increase our HP or hit points to the maximum. Alright, on this one I had a slight tough decision between crit and recovery. Let's go back to our main character really, really quick and take a look at our stats. As you noticed, our recovery is not looking really all that great because it's only 1200, so we definitely want to bring our recovery a little high. Our deflection is pretty low, but that's okay because I'm currently missing pretty much all the artifacts there at the bottom along with all the enchantments. So we'll go ahead and pick recovery instead of crit. I love sharing everything I know with you guys, with all my subscribers and my fans. This game certainly does not come with instructions. So it's because of us, you and me together, makes the game experience a lot more fun. We're almost done. We'll go ahead and pick 2% resistance, and then we'll pick some stamina gain instead of anything else, since I'm always running out of stamina. And there we go, guys. This one gives you an extra 3,000 more hit points. Can't get better than that. Alright, let's go ahead and submit. Go back to the character page. As you noticed, we're up to 161,000 hit points. And I still haven't put my artifact in. Well, let's go ahead and select the wheels. It gives you an extra 4,000 more. We'll go ahead and select the GWF artifact. This one gives you an extra 2,000 more hit points. And we'll go ahead and select the Earth. Which I have to get it all the way up to maxed, and which will give me an additional 4,000 more hit points. And of course, we'll go ahead and select the main piece, which is goes together with my belt and my necklace. We'll go ahead and switch to the Everfrost pants and shirts. As you notice, my HP there at the top is certainly climbing up. We're up to 173,000, guys. Very close to 200,000. And I still have not inserted all my enchantments into my defense slots. Alright, now it's time to go ahead and put all the enchantments in their places where they belong. Let's go ahead and put in the Transcendent Negation, along with the Radiant Rank 12. I do want to shout out to Glitcher again. He's the one that gave me 5 Radiance at Rank 12. Just absolutely amazing. Also, shout out to Ren. Ren sent me a bunch of stuff in my email. A bunch of rank 9s and a bunch of rank 10s. And I think there was a few of 11s in there. So, I appreciate the support that some of you have been showing the love to Mini-Me. I really do. And for those that are wondering why I'm picking all these Radiants at rank 12 to put them as my defense slot, is because they give you HP. 2400 to be exact. And again, this build is based on HP. The goal is to get the HP as high as it can go. With the current setup I have. So all the defense slot along with the offense slots, I'm going to pick the Radiant 12s. As you notice, my HP just keeps going higher and higher every time I insert one of those. Also, let's go ahead and switch to the Prestige arm piece. That's going to certainly bring our HP a little higher as well. And one thing I forgot, let's go ahead and remove the rank 12 out of here. This is what I was waiting to show you guys earlier. That was something to do with the rings that I had gotten. It was very painful trying to obtain the chest piece here. If you notice, guys, it gives you 50,000 HP. 50,495 to be exact, which is absolutely awesome. And the way I got it, I'll go ahead and explain it. If you want to get it for a CW, Trickster Rogue, or an HR, you would have to do the Prophecy of Madness. If you want to get it for a GWF, a GF, or Paladin, you would have to complete the Throne of the Dwarven Gods. After about 50 times of playing, I finally got the chest piece. So I'm just going to show you the easy way, guys. This is using my PvE setup build, which, again, it will be tied into the link on the description below, along with at the end of the video as well. Watch me smash the boss here. Ah! Let's take a look at our list. Not bad, 145 kills for a GF. Look at that, 35 million. Not so bad. The GF usually suck at the leaderboards when it comes to PvE stuff, because our rotation is so damn slow. So here we go. I did finally get the chest piece, which it was very painful, guys, because it was so repetitive over and over. So we went up all the way to 219,000. Let's go ahead and put the Radiant rank 12. Along with our Transcendent Negation, and we're up to about 222,000 now. And let's go ahead and put in all the darks. All right, so with all the darks in place, let's take a look at our HP, 222,000. If you notice, if we drink some of these potions, they will increase our HP by a lot, especially if you drink the Caprice potion. It will definitely bring the HP up like crazy, because the Caprice is based on the percentage of your HP. Under my mount and my insignia bonuses, what we're going to do is we're going to select our insignias. I'm going to swap them out with the one that gives you HP. Let's go over these ones really, really quick. The insignia bonus I've selected on this mount is the one that heals you. And it heals you pretty good, about 10% when somebody does at least 35% damage to your hit points. The next mount, this one heals you 20% to your total maximum hit points when you drop below 50%. The third mount on the list, this one heals you when you deflect an attack. Even though my deflection is not that good, it still works pretty decent. The fourth mount on the list, this one gives you 15% speed when your stamina is above 75%. When it drops below 75%, it gives you power instead. And then the last mount, this one heals you some more when you're being immobilized, knocked, or controlled. Alright, now that we're back here, let's talk about the potion. This is the potion of heroism. This one will increase all your ability scores, which is your main, your secondary, and the third. In my case, would be Strength, Constitution, and Dexterity by 1 point. And you notice it brought us to 224,000 hit points. The next one is called the Potion of Fate. This one will increase every single one of them by 1 point. This is also going to increase our hit points to 225,000, since it increased the Constitution. Now the Caprice, here's the one I was talking about. It gives you an extra 8,258. Now this is based on your percentage of your hit points. So if your hit points are rather low, you're not going to get that much hit points out of it. Here's another one, which is called the Prime Rib. You can get this one at your local grocery store. I'm just joking, guys. And your Guildhall store. They are pretty pricey. I guess it all depends on how often you like to do your influence. They are about 350. Alright, now let's go back to the main character sheet. If you noticed, once I use it, my HP goes all the way up to 243,000, guys. And with the VIP included, the VIP also gives you additional HP or hit points when you're in PvP. Alright, let's go under the mount section, and we're going to swap some of the insignias out with the HP insignias. The purple insignias for HP, they'll give you about an extra 800 HP, so you can really, really increase your HP like crazy if you were to swap out all your insignias with the HP insignias, which each of them, again, gives you an additional 800 HP. In addition to that, if you were to select reinforcement kits, they would also give you an extra 800 HP on each one of them, Also, in addition to that, if you were to have the Metallic Dragonborn, which gives you extra HP on top of that, I mean, we're talking about you can easily rock 300,000 HP. I know it sounds unrealistic and out of proportion, but it's true. I still have not even selected the new boons yet that just came out recently on this new mod, which gives you an extra 6,500 more HP just out of those boons alone. Let's go ahead and select all the powers until the PvP pops. I really am so curious to try this in PvP and see how well it does. I mean, come on guys, 252,000 HP, you'll notice once I go in PvP because of the VIP gives you an extra HP. Especially if you're in a pre-made, you'll also get an additional HP as well. Your stats on a pre-made are so much better. Everything goes higher. Your power can go higher, your HP can go higher, armor pen can go higher. It all depends, I guess, who you have on your party. As far as this GF build goes, guys, I hope you enjoyed it. This build, again, is useful for any other class out there that's looking to raise your HP. The feats may not be applying to you, but you can certainly take the advantage of the boons and the setup that I'm doing. This setup would be amazing on a class that does a lot of deflection. Can you imagine having all the Insignia bonus that deflect and heal you? Especially if your HP is 250,000. Remember, the higher the HP, the bigger the heals. Ooh, looks like PvP popped, guys. I hope I can finish this just in time before we can get to join in.
Oh, shit, dude. It's fucking hot. For every HP,
set at 210.
Yeah. I don't know why. Okay, one shot. It's actually kind of scary.
Smash.
Gildar got smashed. You fight in 1-on-1 or you want to smash the tip?
Yeah, I'm 1-on-1.
Are you using Daring Shout?
I am.
Zin Ravioli.
Oh, come on.
The three go away.
Because he keeps, he's so squishy, dude. I'm telling you. No, because he's all DPS build. That's it. He has no defense at all.
Like Volkars.
And maybe we should bring him into our party.
That's a lot of DPS, dude. What the fuck? He's right there.
It's a lot of DPS. What? How the hell do you KS a dagger?
That's the 1v1. Oh, he deflected it. Nice close. Like if you're best in slot, you are changing some damage that matters as much as you could switch. If you have mana and legendary weapons and the talent.
Thank you.
My favorite horse has got to be the Black Ice one, the one with the electricity and thunders and all that.
Just drop, you know, 30 mil.
Team dominance.